It has been calculated that if all lactating females on this globe, including humans, of course, would donate only 10% of their mother's milk to those who are starving and have not enough milk to give to their young ones, life on Earth would establish a perfect equilibrium between pleasure and pain, life and death. Even males produce milk if you suck on their tits with insistence for about 6 weeks. Why should males have nipples if this was not true? You would say, life is life and has nothing to do with numbers. Numbers of species surviving, numbers of years in an individual's life, numbers of units per species. And I would answer, you are wrong. Nearly everything has to do with numbers. How many liters of milk per head, just to mention one example. How many blades of grass or ears of wheat? Up to how many proteins each grain of grass can enrich our bodies with, how much of it goes to pay for the tractor and swimming pools and the ensuing treatment for cancer, which is a direct result of stress from wrong decisions. The most beautiful people in the world are the Fulani tribe from Niger, the poorest country in the world. They are nomadic cowherders and live off the milk of the cattle that they mix with millet, that they barter for milk from the sedentary Hausa farmers, who despise them nevertheless and call the nomads Bororos, meaning the dirty ones. The territory is the grassland on the southern fringe of the Sahara, which is not arable enough for agriculture. They are spirit worshippers and are proud to own as few belongings as possible, except cows and camels, of course, making their wandering lighter, and the only instrument they use to make music with is their body. Bronowski claims that man's mind started to soar towards great achievements such as the pyramids and the cathedrals, space travel and saran wrap, when man finally settled down 10,000 years ago and became sedentary. And I say that this is precisely when all hell broke loose and the shit hit the fan. There is no higher man than a Fulani nomad doing his avant-garde facial dance and body music in order to seduce the young maidens watching him, and no more advanced and politically liberated person by letting himself be chosen by any maiden who wants him. Why? Because all of them are beautiful. All of them have exquisite bone structures and white teeth, and their art is their life. And their nourishment is milk and millet.